Hello! Just a quick little set to open the chest a little bit, and we're focusing on the back muscles, the muscles at the back, to keep us from that hunch over where we're sitting in front of our computers and have this sort of roll forward of the shoulders and then the hunching and the curving of the spine at the back. So just a little bit of work now to sort of open, draw the shoulders down, work the muscles at the back to keep the shoulder blades flush on the rib cage, and then opening out the chest and expanding to open the pecs. To when these muscles are tight, they'll draw us forward. When they're relaxed and open, then our chest is open and we can open our hearts and open our chests and breathe. Okay, right. So just to take a deep breath in, take the hand to the ceiling, reach up and over, breathing out. Inhale and stay. And then exhale, bring yourself back to center. So inhale, take your arm to the ceiling. Exhale over. Inhale, stay. And then without using this hand too much, use this oblique muscle to bring you back. Another side. So we're just putting a bit of lateral flexion into the spine before we start extending it. Okay. So just take a deep breath in and open your arms wide and push them a little bit back and then bring them forward. Inhale back, exhale forward. So just feel it quite expansive. Reach them out to the sides, arms out and slightly back without moving your body, without going into an arch, sort of trying to keep the back straight and grow taller, and up and back. Okay, staying, we'll go into this position with a bent knee, back as straight as you can get it. Roll your shoulders back and down, and keep that sort of, not jamming them back, but a gentle drawing down at the back into a V, so that the scapula are drawing down the back, rather than clenched back and squeezing back. It's gentle. There's still a gap between the shoulder blades, if you can feel that going back. Place your hands on your legs. Take a deep breath in. And as you exhale, hinge forward from the hips so your back is staying nice and straight. So you're pressing into the mat with your sit bones and your coccyx to lengthen the head up to the ceiling and put space in the spine this way. Okay, and take a breath in, take your arm up to the, and breathe out. Now push back slightly with the hands, just by your ears, keeping the back nice and straight. A few little pulses, challenging the shoulders, bring the arms back down, breathe in, and bend over. So this will come a bit more naturally to you. But then lengthen, bring your chest close to your knees, and then lengthen the head out further on a diagonal. So again, your bottom's pressing into the mat, and you're reaching the head up towards the corner of the room. Shoulders are drawing down the back all the time. And now from this point, press the triceps back. You can have a weight in your hand for this, but it's not necessary. We just want the sensation on the back of the body, pressing back. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then over and roll back up. Straighten out your legs. So stretching the hamstrings a little bit. Again, okay. Hinge forward from the hip. Hold on to where you arrive. It might be here, it might be here. But wherever you are, try and use the arms and the pulling on your legs to draw your shoulder blades down, and again, reaching away. Breathe deeply here. Take your arm up and the other arm and press back from this position. One. It's too hard to keep your legs straight. Put a bend in them. That's fine. working the muscles on the back of the body. One, two, three, four, five, and come up. Okay, I'm gonna roll over. So that was 5 minutes like that. We'll do another 5 minutes on the tummy. Okay, so to begin with, put your legs a little bit apart and rotate them out. So your knees are facing slightly out and your toes are pointing out towards the mat. Now find a position for your hands will change for everybody. But you want your pubic bone to be pressing into the mat. Draw your shoulders down. Take a deep breath in. As you breathe out, feel your belly button sort of lift away from your shirt or away from the mat. It won't actually happen, but you want that sensation, the engagement and the compressing of the abdominals back in towards the body and a tightening around the waist. So maintain that sensation as much as you can to keep the spine supported. Take a deep breath in, and as you breathe out, start to push into your fingers, into your hands, and start to raise the body up off the mat. So it's not a back bend, we're lifting from here as well as in the back here. Take a deep breath in, and as you breathe out, lengthen back down towards the mat. Inhale and exhale. Push yourself back up. Okay, squeeze your bottom a little bit, or light engagement. Squeezing's not a great word. And then come all the way down. Take your arms out long. And then, first of all, lift one arm and place it down. The other, place it down. The head is always in line with the spine, okay? So you're not looking up or head down. Keep a nice alignment of the spine all the way along. Now bring left arm, right leg. So you're keeping the engagement of the abdominals, just to keep the body stable. Lift the pelvic floor. Shoulder blades are down, so the arms aren't up by the shoulders. They're drawing down as you lift them up. And then at the end, we'll do one long superman. Hover, hold your abdominals at the pelvic floor. Shoulders again are up, they're drawing down. And release down. Last exercise here. Place your arms by the side. Take your breath in and exhale. Roll the shoulders back and hover off the mat. And release down. So inhale. Inhale, shoulders come back. It's on the exhale. Hover long like a torpedo through the water. Neck in line, head in line with the spine. And back down, last one. You can change the neck each time. Or nose almost touching the mat. Inhale, shoulders go back. Exhale. And down. Push yourself back up into child's pose. Take a deep breath in and out and in and out. Roll yourself back up, roll the shoulders out.